This is the first video in the Sky ATP Getting Started video series. In order to get the most from this series, users attempting to enroll in and use Sky ATP should have the following. Some familiarity with the Junos operating system as it pertains to SRX series devices, familiarity with entering commands in a command line interface, and experience using a web browser to fill out and gather data from online forms. In addition, you must have an SSH connection to an internet-connected SRX series device in order to complete some needed configuration and to kick off the connection to the Sky ATP web portal. At the time of release of this video, supported SRX series devices are SRX 340, 345, 550M, 1500, 4100, 4200, 4600, 5400, 5600, 5800, and all sizes of VSRX. Note that for SRX 340, 345, and 550M, as a part of the initial device configuration, you must configure Set Security Forwarding Process Enhanced Services Mode and reboot the device before continuing with the configuration. You must also be able to make a web browser connection to the Sky ATP web portal at sky.junipersecurity.net using a supported web browser. Supported browsers include Google Chrome and Firefox. Juniper Sky Advanced Threat Protection, or Sky ATP, is a cloud-based service that provides complete advanced protection against malware, ransomware, unknown threats, and zero-day attacks by monitoring ingress and egress network traffic, looking for malware and other indicators of compromise. Using a pipeline of technologies, Juniper Sky ATP delivers progressive verdicts that assess the risk level of each potential attack. Hosted securely in the cloud, Juniper Sky ATP integrates with Juniper Network's SRX series services gateways to deliver deep inspection, inline malware blocking, and actionable reporting. This video series covers the initial steps involved with setting up Sky ATP and your SRX devices to work together as shown in the graphic on screen. For detailed documentation regarding Sky ATP and the technologies shown in the graphic, click the links in the description. Configure SRX for Sky ATP. Any device that you intend to enroll in Sky ATP must have the following things configured in order for the enrollment to succeed. Root authentication. In this example, we set root authentication with a plain text password. The password is not shown when entered. Other authentication options are available. System host name. Here we set the host name as SRX-345. A default route. The default route is used when there is no known route to a destination. One or more interfaces in the untrust security zone. Here we are setting two logical interfaces in the untrust zone. GE-0/0/2.0 and GE-0/0/5.0. One or more interfaces in the trust security zone. Here we assign the logical interface GE-0/0/4.0 in the trust security zone. A connection to a DNS name server. This setting enables the SRX to resolve host names to IP addresses. The Network Time Protocol, NTP, must be enabled and working. The three commands here enable NTP on the SRX and tell it where the time server is located. Both the routing engine and packet forwarding engines must be able to reach the internet. If there is a firewall between the device and the internet, then ports 8080 and 443 must be open on that firewall. For detailed instructions, use the link in the description to view specific documentation.